Welcome to MSBT Online Learning Program, Learning at Your Doorstep. This is Professor Pankaj Zadich, lecturer, Guru Gobind Singh Polytechnic, Nasik. So we continue our discussion on 8051 Memory and I/O Devices Interfacing. This presentation will focus on interfacing of stepper motor with 8051 microcontroller. After this presentation, students will be able to state terms related to stepper motor, interface stepper motor with 8051 microcontroller, write assembly language program to rotate stepper motor clockwise and counterclockwise, that is anti-clockwise, list application of stepper motor. Next, we have the concept map. So microcontroller cannot be directly connected to stepper motor as the output current of microcontroller is not enough to drive the motor. What we need is a driver to boost the output current of microcontroller. Let us look into some basics of stepper motor. Nice photo of stepper motor and the internal circuitry. It is a brushless synchronous electric motor that divides complete rotation into number of steps, hence the name stepper motor. The best feature of the stepper motor is that angular position can be accurately controlled without any feedback mechanism. Thus, it works in a simple, accurate open loop system where output is directly dependent on the input. A stepper motor rotates at small angles of complete 360 degree rotations. These small angles are called steps, hence the name stepper motor. Typically, a stepper motor consists of 200 steps equals to 360 degree. Thus, each step is 1.8 degree. Some definitions related to stepper motor. First is the step angle. It is the angle in which motor moves when one pulse is applied as input of stator. The parameter used to determine the position of stepper motor is step angle. It is given by ns minus nr upon ns plus nr whole into 360, where ns is number of stator poles and nr is number of rotor poles. Steps per revolution. These are the number of steps required to complete one revolution. So formula is simple, it is 360 degree upon step angle. Steps per second. This parameter is used to measure a number of steps covered in each second. So steps per second is RPM into steps per revolution by 60. RPM is revolution per minute. It means the frequency of rotation. By this parameter, we can measure the number of rotations in 1 minute. Students can now attempt the MCQs from set 1. Next, we have interfacing of stepper motor with 8051 microcontroller. Now, it is very easy. We need to give 0 and 1 to 4 wires of stepper motor according to the mode of run that is used. But before we do that, we need to find out 4 coil wires and 2 common wires very carefully, otherwise motor won't rotate. The 4 ends of the coils are connected to the 4 pins of 8051 through ULN2003 driver. Rest 2 wires should be connected to proper supply depending on the stepper motor. These are the 2 common end wires. 8051, as we have discussed, does not provide enough current, so we are going to use driver IC ULN 2003. There are two modes we will be discussing in this presentation. One is full drive mode and the other is half drive mode. Let us sketch the interfacing of stepper motor with 8051. So this is microcontroller 8051. On port 1, the ULN2003 driver IC is connected. The four windings are connected to the IC and the common wire is connected to supply. Now there are two modes. The first one is full drive mode. In this mode, two coils are energized at the same time. This mode produces more torque and hence power consumption is also high. You will see the table. So if you see here, A and B windings are energized simultaneously, C and D are not. Then B and C are energized, then C, D are energized, and then D and A is energized. And this can be written as a hex code. C639. This is the sequence for clockwise rotation of stepper motor. Reversed, it will give anti-clockwise rotation. We will see a program to rotate the motor in clockwise direction for full drive mode. So mode 1, timer mode 1 is used here, and the sequence are loaded as C639 for clockwise, and there is a delay that is being called after each sequence is loaded. And sequence is loaded on port 1 because motor is connected on port 1. This is the delay to generate 200 milliseconds. In case delay is reduced, the speed of motor will increase. So this is the delay program to set the speed of the motor. Another way of writing the above program and rotating motor continuously is we load immediate data 66H in accumulator, and then accumulator is moved to port 1 to issue the sequence to the motor as motor is connected on port 1. Now the accumulator is rotated right to rotate motor clockwise. Once we do that, 66H will become 33H, again rotated right it will become 99H, and then it will become CCH. This can be checked, but we are only loading the 4 bits in port 1 because only 4 pins of port 1s are used. Delay is called and then this keeps rotating continuously. We can change the speed of the motor by changing the delay. For rotating anti-clockwise or counter-clockwise, instead of rotate right accumulator, we can use rotate left accumulator. So we can compare that we have reduced the number of programming steps. Now let's look in half drive mode. In half drive mode, 1 and 2 coils are energized alternately. Like first one coil is energized, then two coils are energized, and so on. The advantage is better resolution in half drive mode. Let us look at the table. So winding A is energized first, then A and B are energized, then only B is energized, then B and C is energized, and so on. Using the hex code, we get this sequence. The program is for clockwise. You will use sequence in this this sequence. For counterclockwise, opposite sequence or sequence needs to be reversed. Program for half drive mode. It can be seen. It is similar to program in full drive mode. Only thing is, instead of 4 sequences, we are having 8 sequences and they are separated by delays. And this is the program to generate the delay. Setting the value of delay will change the speed of the motor. We'll take one example. Write a program in ALP to rotate 4 phase stepper motor to generate 4 step sequence and rotate it in clockwise direction to 180 degree. Motor has 1.8 degree step angle. So for such a case, we first need to get the sequence and we need to get the value to load the sequence. So step angle is 1.8 degree. So number of steps required is 100 and there are 4 step sequence. So 100 is divided by 4 to get 25, which in hexadecimal is 19H. For clockwise, we know the sequence is C639. Let us write the program. So here step is set by using move arrow comma immediate data 19H. The PTR is used to load the step. So the step is set in the lookup table here, C639 for clockwise, and reverse it will give you anti-clockwise direction. Accumulator is cleared. Whenever we use add DPTR to load from the lookup table, move C is used here, then this accumulator is loaded in port 0. In case we are connecting it to port 0, motor is connected to port 0. DPTR is incremented to load the next sequence. Delay is called. And then we use decrement counter because we are using 4 step sequence. So it will be having counter is set up to count number of steps and then stop once the count is over. This is the program for the example that is given. Applications of stepper motor in real life. They are used in dot matrix printers. They are used in tape drivers, floppy disk drivers, printers, electric watches. Used in metal cutting and metal forming machines. They are widely used in textile industry. Used in integrated circuit fabrication. Students can now attempt MCQs from set 2. Points to remember from our discussion: calculation of step angle of rotation for stepper motor, sketching the interface of microcontroller with stepper motor, ALP to rotate motor in different modes, modify ALP to change the direction of rotation of stepper motor with reference to the sequence or rotate right or rotate left.